Have you ever wondered how digital audio truly captures sound? Technologies like high-resolution PCM and DSD are everywhere, promising pristine audio quality. But the fundamental principles behind them, especially the fascinating process of delta-sigma modulation used in most modern ADCs and DACs, often remain a bit of a mystery, even for enthusiasts and engineers. Understanding how analog signals are converted into dense digital streams and how quantization noise is cleverly managed is key to appreciating the nuances of digital audio. However, visualizing this complex high-speed process can be challenging. That's why today I'd like to introduce DSD Explained. It's an interactive web application I developed, designed specifically to demystify delta-sigma modulation. DSD Explained animates the entire process of modulation and reconstruction in slow motion, making it easy to grasp exactly what's happening under the hood. You can launch the app directly in your web browser. The link is in the video description below. No installation is needed. So, what can you do with DSD Explained? Its core feature is the real-time animation of both standard 1-bit delta sigma, like DSD, and multi-bit delta sigma conversion and reconstruction. You can see the input waveform, the resulting digital bitstream, and the final reconstructed waveform all evolving step by step. Crucially, you have full control over the key parameters. You can adjust the oversampling frequency, the quantization bit depth, the order of the noise shaping, the input signal frequency, and even the characteristics of the reconstruction low-pass filter. Alongside the time domain waveforms, the app displays a real-time FFT spectrum analyzer. This is incredibly useful for seeing how quantization noise is shaped and pushed out of the audio band by the delta-sigma modulator and how the low-pass filter removes it during reconstruction. And perhaps most importantly for learning, you can drastically slow down the simulation speed. This allows you to observe the detailed interaction between the input signal, the quantization process, and the feedback loop at a pace that's easy to follow. Let's take a closer look at the configuration options and what they mean, both in the real world and in this simulation. First, the speed slider. This controls the slow motion playback for visualization. Lower values make the animation slower. Remember, this is purely a demonstration feature to help understanding. It doesn't correspond to any parameter in a real ADDA converter. Next, oversampling frequency. You can choose ratios like 64, 128, 256, or 512 times the base rate of 44.1 kHz. In a real ADC, this is the core sampling rate setting. Higher oversampling spreads the unavoidable quantization noise over a much wider frequency range. This significantly reduces the noise within the audible band, improving the signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR. The trade-off in real hardware is increased power consumption and circuit complexity. Watch the FFT display as you change this. You'll see the noise floor change shape dramatically. Then, we have the AD bit depth. This slider lets you move from 1-bit, like traditional DSD, up to 6 bits. In real converters, each additional bit increases the dynamic range by approximately 6 decibels and directly reduces the quantization noise floor. With this app, you can visually compare the coarse 1-bit quantization against finer multi-bit steps and see the immediate impact on the digital waveform and the noise level in the FFT before noise shaping. The signal frequency slider simply sets the frequency of the input we're converting, In practice, engineers use different frequencies to test a converter's frequency response and check for issues like aliasing. Now, a crucial parameter, noise shaping order. This ranges from 0, which disables noise shaping entirely, up to 6th order. This determines the complexity of the delta sigma modulator's feedback loop. The magic of delta sigma is noise shaping. It pushes quantization noise out of the low frequency audio band and up into the ultrasonic range. Higher orders do this much more aggressively. For instance, a second order shaper can lower in-band noise by about 12 decibels compared to a first order one. Watch the FFT. As you increase the order, you'll see the noise floor dramatically decrease at low frequencies and rise sharply at high frequencies. The trade-off? Higher orders mean more complex and potentially less stable feedback loops in our real circuits. The waveform display. Toggles let you choose which signals to view. Original is the pure input sine wave, in blue. Digital is the raw quantized output of the modulator, in yellow, appearing as pulses for 1-bit or steps for multi-bit. And reconstructed is the final output after the low-pass filter, in red. Finally, we have the reconstruction LPF cutoff frequency and LPF order. After the delta sigma modulation, we have a digital signal with lots of high-frequency noise. To get back to an analog signal or a standard PCM signal, this noise must be removed with a steep low-pass filter. The cutoff frequency sets where this filter starts rolling off. Setting it lower removes more noise but might start to attenuate the desired audio frequencies if set too low. The LPF order controls how steeply the filter cuts off frequencies above the cutoff. A higher order, like eighth order, providing a 48 decibels per octave slope, gives better noise rejection but, in real analog circuits, can introduce phase distortion and increase complexity. You can observe the effect of these filter settings directly on the reconstructed waveform and its spectrum in the FFT display. Let's see some examples in action. Here we have a standard 1-bit setup, a 64fs oversampling and 6th order noise shaping. Typical DSD 64 parameters. Notice the dense stream of yellow pulses in the time domain and the characteristic noise shape in the FFT. Very low noise in the audio band, rising sharply at higher frequencies. The red reconstructed waveform closely follows the original blue input. Now, let's switch the AD bit depth to 5 bits, keeping everything else the same. See how the yellow digital waveform now shows distinct steps. The quantization is much finer. Look at the FFT. The overall noise floor before shaping is lower, and even after 6th order shaping, the noise in the audio band is further reduced compared to the 1-bit case. This demonstrates the principle behind multi-bit delta sigma converters. What happens if we turn off noise shaping? Let's set the noise shaping order to 0. Immediately, look at the FFT. The quantization noise is now flat across the spectrum, like in basic PCM. The noise level within the audio band is significantly higher without the shaping effect. The reconstructed signal, red, might look noisier too. Let's turn noise shaping back onto 6th order. Now, observe the effect of the LPF. If I drastically lower the LPF cutoff frequency, say down to 20 kHz, the high frequency noise in the reconstructed signal spectrum is heavily attenuated. If I lower the LPF order, the filter slope becomes gentler, and you can see more high-frequency noise remaining in the reconstructed signal spectrum. As you can see, DSD Explained provides a powerful visual way to explore the fascinating world of delta sigma modulation. Whether you're a student learning digital signal processing, an engineer designing or evaluating audio converters, or an audiophile curious about how DSD and high-resolution audio works, this tool lets you experiment and build intuition, play with the parameters, observe the waveforms and spectrum, and see for yourself how oversampling, bit depth, noise shaping, and filtering all interact to achieve high-fidelity digital audio. You can access the DSD Explained web app using the link in the description. You'll also find a link to the README file there, which provides detailed explanations of all the parameters. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you find DSD Explained a helpful tool for understanding this essential digital audio technology.